said that there were 124,000 messengers sent on the face of the earth. 124,000 messengers sent on the face of the earth. By name, only 25 are mentioned in the glorious Quran. But all the messengers that came before the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they were only sent for their people. And the complete message which they got was meant for a particular time period. All the messengers that came before Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, they were only meant for their people, and the complete message was meant for a particular time period. For example, the glorious Quran says in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse number 49, that we appoint Jesus, peace be upon him, as a messenger to the Bani Israel. Jesus, peace be upon him, came as a messenger only to the children of Israel. And the similar message is given in the Bible, in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 10, verse number 5 to 6, where it says that Jesus, peace be upon him, tells his 12 disciples that go ye not into the way of the Gentiles. Who are the Gentiles? The non-Jews, the Hindus, the Muslims. Jesus, peace be upon him, tells the disciples that go ye not into the way of the Gentiles. Into the city of the Samaritans ye shall enter not, but rather go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Jesus, peace be upon him, told the disciples that only go to the children of Israel. Jesus, peace be upon him, himself further says in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 15, verse number 24, where he says that I have not been sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Jesus, peace be upon him, came as a messenger only for the Jews, only for the children of Israel, not for the whole of humanity. The Quran says in Surah Ahzab, chapter 33, verse number 40, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِّن رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَاقِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ كَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. That Muhammad, peace be upon him, is not the father of any of your sons, but is a messenger of Allah and is the seal of the prophets. Allah is all-knowing, full of knowledge. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last and final messenger. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was not sent only for the Muslims, but only for the Arabs. The Quran says in Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter 21, verse number 107, it says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that we have sent thee not but as a mercy to all the creatures, as a mercy to all the worlds, as a mercy to the whole of humanity. The Quran says in Surah Sabah, chapter 34, verse number 28, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا, that we have sent thee as a universal messenger, giving glad tidings and warning them against sin. But most of humanity yet do not know. So Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was the last and final messenger, and he was not sent only for the Muslims or the Arabs, he was sent for the whole of humanity. And the prophecy of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is mentioned in various world religious scriptures, including the Christian scriptures. If you read in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18, it says that I shall raise thee up a prophet from among thy brethren, like unto thee, and I shall put my words into his mouth, and he shall speak all that I command him. This is a prophecy of the coming of a prophet, which if you ask the tradition, many will say that this prophecy actually refers to Jesus, peace be upon him. And when you ask them that how does it refer to Jesus, peace be upon him, so they will tell you that the prophecy says, I shall raise thee up a prophet from among thy brethren, like unto thee, like unto Moses, peace be upon him. So if the prophet is like Moses, then it indicates that prophet is the person mentioned in this prophecy. And they say that Jesus and Moses, peace be upon them both, they were alike. And the reason they give is that, see, Moses, peace be upon him, was a prophet of God. Even Jesus, peace be upon him, was a prophet of God. Moses, peace be upon him, was a Jew. Jesus, peace be upon him, was also a Jew. So they give two similarities. And when we ask them that are these two similarities sufficient to prove that this prophecy indicates only to Jesus, peace be upon him, and they will agree with it. If these two are the only criterias for fulfillment of that prophecy, then all the prophets mentioned in the Bible that came after Moses, peace be upon him, like Solomon, Isaiah, Ezekiel, Daniel, Joel, John, Hosea, all of them were prophets of Almighty God, and all of them were Jewish. So all these prophets mentioned after Moses, peace be upon him, in the Bible, fulfilled these prophecies. In fact, if you analyze, this prophecy of Deuteronomy, chapter number 18, verse number 18, befits no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Because if you analyze, Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them both, they both had a natural birth. They had a father as well as a mother. Jesus, peace be upon him, according to the glorious Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse 43 to 47, he was born miraculously without any male intervention. And the same message is given in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 1, verse number 18, as well as Gospel of Luke, chapter number 1, verse number 35, that Jesus, peace be upon him, was born miraculously. He had no worldly father. So if you analyze, Moses, peace be upon him, was like Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and unlike Jesus, peace be upon him. Both Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them, they were married and they had children. According to the Bible, Jesus, peace be upon him, he was not married, neither did he have any children. Both Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them, they had natural deaths. Jesus, peace be upon him, he did not have a natural death. According to the glorious Quran, the Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse number 157 and 58, it says Jesus, peace be upon him, was raised up alive. He did not die. And according to the church, the Bible says that Jesus, peace be upon him, he was crucified on the cross. In both the ways, he did not have a natural death. So Moses, peace be upon him, was unlike Jesus, peace be upon him. And further, if you analyze, Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them both, they were both accepted by the people. The people accepted them. But the Gospel of John, chapter number 1, verse number 11 says that when Jesus went, his own did not receive him. And Jesus' own people did not receive him. And if you analyze, Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them both, besides being prophets of Almighty God, they were even kings. Kings means they could give a punishment, a capital punishment of death, to whoever they wanted, whoever committed a crime. Besides being prophets of God, they were even head of states or kings of that world at that particular time. But Jesus, peace be upon him, says, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 18, verse number 36, my kingdom is not of this world. That means Jesus, peace be upon him, was not a worldly king. So if you analyze, Moses and Muhammad, peace be upon them both, they were alike. But Moses and Jesus, peace be upon them, they were not alike. So this prophecy befits no one better than the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Further, the prophecy reads, I shall raise thee up a prophet from among thy brethren. Brethren means relatives. And we know the Jews and the Arabs, we are relatives of each other. And further, the prophecy says that I shall put my words into his mouth. And we know that whatever revelation our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam received, he verbatim repeated that as though words were put in his mouth. This complete prophecy exactly befits Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. There's a further prophecy mentioned in the book of Isaiah, chapter number 12, verse number 29, that the book shall be given to a person who's not learned. And when he'll be asked, pray, read this, he will say, I am not learned. And we know when the first revelation that was revealed to beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that from Surah Iqra, Surah Alaq, chapter 96, verse number 1, Iqra, when Archangel